So most of you guys are aware that Tim Dillon's producer Ben Avery, and a really integral part of the show, because especially someone like myself who's a big fan of the Tim Dillon show, Ben's like is essentially like a co-host. You know, Tim kind of riffs off him really well. They have this really cool style of doing the show where it's mostly a solo show, but Tim rants, and he kind of rants in the direction of Ben, who kind of acts as the audience and also the producer, who's meant to be pulling up things. You know, sometimes he pulls them up well, but he doesn't pull them up well. Sometimes he's not paying attention, but you know, their chemistry in general, their kind of, you know, way of talking to each other was always really entertaining. And for whatever reason, out of the blue, Ben basically left. And I think those rumors are happening already on the subreddit that he was leaving, because I think some of the episodes where he wasn't a producer, he wasn't featured in the notes, which are really strange. Really strange, right? Somebody mentioned, because I don't ever read the notes of the fucking podcast. You know where they put like the links for the sponsors and shit and the social media stuff? I guess people keep an eye on that sort of thing. And somebody mentioned that someone noticed that his name wasn't on the producer credits or even the editor credits or whatever, even if he's not there. And then that kind of started the rumors. And then out of the blue, Ben then kind of confirmed it. No, then I think he subreddit that he had, not subreddit, sorry, a Discord that he had, suddenly went kaput. And then obviously people kind of figured out that maybe something was going on. And then Ben decided to release a statement also, basically clarifying that he had decided to leave. Because the early rumors were that Tim fired him because they were having some really... Because again, I'm a fan of the show. I listen to it every single week. I'm even signed up to the Patreon. I even pay for it. It's the only Patreon I legitimately pay for. And I remember them having a lot of arguments and stuff. Like, you know, like kind of best friends, brothers type arguments. But a lot of it kind of felt like it was rooted in some kind of truth, because Tim was being a little bit too heavy-handed with his insults towards Ben in terms of him not being good at his job and he could easily be replaced and he's threatening to fire him. That bit didn't really maybe, I think, land or hit the way he thought it did. And then somebody mentioned that Ben went in, recently, that Ben kind of, you know, doesn't really respond too well to Steve or do it. One of the kind of former Nelk Boy type people, and Tim basically goes in on him because I guess Steve would do it, sponsors that podcast and offers him a lot, gives him a lot of money and shit, so he wasn't too happy with Ben kind of getting at him. But anyway, there was a lot of kind of friction between the both of them, so people thought initially that it might have been a consequence of that friction, and the natural culmination of it was that Ben would get fired. But he cleared up and said that he's the one that left actually to pursue other ventures. So this is his tweet explaining the situation. It says, I've been receiving a lot of messages and comments about this, so I wanted to say something publicly. Unfortunately, I no longer work on the show as of the last few weeks. I'm extremely great. He didn't even write Tim's name, right? Did he write Tim? Oh, that's very bitchy. That looks like, okay, Tim at the end. I should be grateful for the time and the show and what it has meant to so many people. I wish nothing but the best for Tim. I'm also thankful for the support from all the people who have emailed and messaged me over the years or I have met in person. It means a lot to me. I'm working on some projects now and I'm excited to share them with all you as soon as I can. So he decided to legitimately leave and do his own thing. And more power to the guy. I guess he didn't want to be the laughing track at the back, which is crazy considering how much he was probably getting paid pretty decently to do such a job. I don't really understand it, but from what Tim has said in the follow-up podcast, he basically didn't feel like he was creatively, you know, he didn't feel like he was doing the things that he was wanting to do creatively. He kind of felt like the podcast was quite limiting in that respect. But still, again, the money that they make, you know, I would just would imagine maybe just phoning it in for a few more months would have been helpful. Maybe to start your own thing. But, you know, sometimes if it's not for you, it's not for you. So bless the guy.